I've been using Adobe Premiere Pro since version CS5 way back in 2010. But in the last several years, I've also been learning DaVinci Resolve. And in this video, I want to give you my thoughts on DaVinci Resolve from a Premiere Pro user's perspective. Also, if you've been thinking about learning DaVinci Resolve, especially if you are a wedding filmmaker, I want you to know that I have a brand new course that I just released called Wedding Film Framework for DaVinci Resolve. And this course is going to show you literally everything that you need to know to be able to quickly edit story-driven wedding films in Resolve. So if you have been considering switching from Premiere Pro or Final Cut Pro or any other editor to DaVinci Resolve, this course is going to show you how to easily do it, and I'll be with you through every step, showing you my proven and efficient system for editing. You can check out Wedding Film Framework for DaVinci Resolve in the description down below. Now, coming from Premiere Pro and learning DaVinci Resolve, the first thing that I noticed when using Resolve was just how similar it felt to Premiere Pro. If you're someone that's worried about needing to take a long time to learn Resolve, I would fight against that fear, because once you open Resolve and get into it, as long as you know your way around Premiere Pro, you should be able to pick up using Resolve fairly quickly. Let me put it this way. What you're going to discover, like I did, is that DaVinci Resolve makes sense in the same way that Premiere Pro makes sense. For example, in both programs, of course, there is a timeline that you're going to be editing and cutting video on. These timelines that you're editing on are going to have tracks that feel very familiar, and I would say that going from Premiere Pro to DaVinci Resolve is significantly easier than going from Premiere Pro to, say, Final Cut Pro, for example, because with Final Cut, you have to learn the magnetic timeline, which is definitely a slightly different way of doing things. Now, getting away from the similarities of these two programs for a second, easily one of the biggest differences between Premiere Pro and DaVinci Resolve is that Adobe has built Premiere Pro to work in an app ecosystem where you have Premiere Pro to edit your videos, you have Adobe Audition to do advanced sound mixing, and Adobe After Effects to do advanced graphics work. You'll have to open each of these programs separately to use them, but one cool feature of Adobe apps is called Dynamic Link, which will allow you to edit a video clip that you're editing in Premiere, in After Effects, or in Adobe Audition in real time. Unfortunately, Dynamic Link is not always the most reliable, which you can leave me a comment down below if you agree with that take or not, but that does lead us into talking about how DaVinci Resolve is different. See, with DaVinci Resolve, on the other hand, you can basically think of it as having all of these separate apps that Premiere Pro has, but they're all in one, and you just toggle between different pages to access them. So if you want to edit your video, you use the edit page or the cut page. If you want to add effects to your video, you use the fusion page. And if you want to mix the audio in your video, you use the Fairlight page. There's no separate programs or dynamic link to worry about, because you never leave the DaVinci Resolve program. It's all there. It's great. And if you think about Resolve as an all-in-one program that replaces many of the Adobe Creative Cloud programs, Resolve is going to make a lot of sense to you. Now, that said, I have heard plenty of feedback from other editors that while it is great that Resolve has all of these features like the Fusion page and the Fairlight page, they are still not quite as robust as having the full After Effects program or the full Adobe Audition program. This is something that I've seen Blackmagic working on, and they are constantly adding new features to the Fusion and Fairlight pages, but I do want you to know that if you do advanced After Effects motion graphics work, or really in-depth audio editing, you may still find Resolve lacking in some aspects. But for the majority of video editors out there, I think you'll be very happy with the amount of features that Resolve has with these pages. Speaking of features, we need to talk about two big things that you're going to notice if you start using Resolve coming from Premiere. One of them is something that Resolve has added that is different than Premiere, and the other is something that, in my opinion, is missing. Let's start with what Resolve has added. One of the biggest differences between DaVinci Resolve and Premiere Pro is that both the color page as well as the fusion page in Resolve use nodes instead of layers when applying effects. This is easily one of the most intimidating parts of going from Premiere Pro to Resolve, but once your brain gets it, you will understand. I actually spend a lot of time in my wedding film framework for DaVinci Resolve course explaining how nodes work to make it easy for you to understand, but for the sake of this video, just know that nodes are a different way of thinking when it comes to editing, and you're going to have to learn them if you want to use the color or fusion page in Resolve. Let's also talk about something that is missing from Resolve now, and this is really fascinating because I consistently see people sharing such positive opinions of DaVinci Resolve. And so whenever I say that Premiere Pro has a feature the Resolve is lacking, people tend to be rather surprised. This feature that you will find yourself missing if you switch from Premiere Pro to DaVinci Resolve is the lack of an Adobe Media Encoder equivalent. Basically, what this means is that if you want to export a video in DaVinci Resolve, you can queue up multiple videos to export, but whenever you click render, Resolve is not going to let you do anything else in the program until the videos are exported. This is significantly different from Premiere Pro, where you can queue up videos in Adobe Media Encoder and then go back to Premiere and continue editing other videos to stay productive. With Resolve, you better make sure that you have time to render because you're not going to be able to do anything else while your videos are exporting. This is a major pain in my opinion, and while Blackmagic has started to introduce programs that can render videos in the background, like the Blackmagic Proxy Generator app that not many people know about, but it's actually really awesome. That's actually another thing that I cover in the Wedding Film Framework for DaVinci Resolve course. Anyways, DaVinci does not have a dedicated standalone video rendering app like Adobe Media Encoder, which I think most filmmakers would really appreciate it because it will help us stay productive even when we're rendering a video. Speaking of staying productive, we need to take a moment to talk about one of the biggest productivity ruiners you may have experienced when you edit in Premiere Pro, and that is bugs and crashes. In short, the sentiment from most video editors that have used Premiere Pro and then switched to DaVinci Resolve, one of the main contributing reasons that many of them switched was that they found Premiere to be prone to crashing at the worst times, which would then cause them to lose work. Now, I have two thoughts about this. First, and this is purely anecdotal, in my experience being someone that edits on a custom-built powerful PC, I have not experienced nearly as many crashes as friends of mine that edit on a Mac. I'm not sure why that is, but at least in my experience and hearing feedback from other filmmakers, Premiere tends to crash more on Mac, and I'm not sure why. So this leads into my second thought, and this may be a bit of a hot take here, but in my experience, I have found that I've had a pretty similar amount of crashes in both Premiere Pro and DaVinci Resolve. Hot take, I know, but it's true. When I'm editing video in either one of these programs, I deal with a few crashes per month. This is usually not a huge deal, but it is interesting that both of them are pretty even in this aspect. But that does lead us into the final difference that we need to talk about that you'll experience if you are switching from Premiere Pro to DaVinci Resolve. And that is, while yes, in my experience, both of these programs crash at roughly the same rate, the difference in the way that these programs handle crashing is dramatically different. Let me explain, because this may blow your mind if you've never used Resolve. I'm not going to go super deep into explaining the intricacies of Resolve's database system. I saved that for you in the Wedding Film Framework course, and it's super helpful, by the way. But here's one of the biggest benefits of Resolve using a database. Unlike Premiere Pro, which uses a .prproj file to save all of your project information into a nice little file, Resolve instead uses a database, which has a ton of benefits, one of the largest being a feature called Live Save. Here's the difference. If Premiere Pro crashes while you're editing a video project and you reopen your project, you are going to be at the mercy of the last time you either manually saved or that you had Premiere auto-saved, which by default is anywhere from 5 to 20 minutes between auto-saves. Alternatively, with DaVinci Resolve and their database magic, because it has this live save feature, every single click and button press that you make when editing is instantly saved. So in the event the Resolve does crash, whenever you reopen the program, you are going to be able to pick up exactly where you left off when it did crash, and you're not going to lose any work. This is a huge benefit, and the first time that I experienced it, where Resolve crashed and then I reopened it, it was magical because everything was right where I left it. I knew that I would have been losing a significant amount of work in Premiere, but I didn't deal with any of that in Resolve. So above all, I'm really impressed by what Blackmagic has created with DaVinci Resolve. And while I still see myself using both Premiere Pro and DaVinci Resolve into the future, especially because I know that Adobe's working to improve Premiere to catch up to Resolve, and I like to see that competition, I really do feel like so many filmmakers are intrigued by DaVinci Resolve and what it has to offer. So, if that is you, if you have been intrigued by DaVinci Resolve, especially if you are a wedding filmmaker and maybe you currently edit in Premiere Pro or Final Cut Pro, I would love for you to check out my new wedding film framework course for DaVinci Resolve. It's going to show you how to quickly edit story-driven wedding films in Resolve. And even if you have never used the program before, I'm going to be with you every step of the way showing you how to edit fast. Heck, speaking of editing fast, maybe you're already editing in DaVinci Resolve, but you're wondering if there's a faster way of doing things. In that case, I would say give this course a chance. Try it out. I'm betting that you're going to learn some things. And what's great is that the course comes with a 60-day money-back guarantee. So you can watch the course, and if you don't learn anything, it's no sweat. I will give you your money back. There is no risk to you. All right, I'll link to Wedding Film Framework for DaVinci Resolve down below. Let me know if you have any questions about the course or if you have thoughts about either DaVinci Resolve or Premiere Pro. Thanks so much for watching, and have a great day.